single pack here today that I'll talk a bit about. This is a 2016 Topps Archives pack that I got at Walmart on sale, $3.48. I don't know what the regular price of this would be, but I'm guessing it would be like $3.99, so it's not that big of a discount. And it was pretty beat up, so who the heck knows what the condition of these cards are. But I don't know if I've opened any archives on this channel before, and thought I'd just sort of tell folks what they're all about. Topps Archives is a set they've been doing for quite a few years now. Basically, what it is see if I can take this off. It's a set that's got a relatively limited selection of star players. The designs, or the design of the cards, are based on past Topps sets. And I think that they sort of use all, you know, years, I think, or at least maybe a handful of years for each set. I haven't quite figured out the rhyme or reason, but, you know, in any given archive set, there'll be like a, you know, an 84 design and a 82 design and an 83 and, you know, a 91. But I don't know, as a collector from the 80s and early 90s, I think it's pretty fun to see modern stars in, you know, the design of sets from many decades ago. Before this set, this line or brand or whatever you want to call it existed, you know, I always kind of wondered, boy, what would it look like if, you know, some player who had an 87 Topps card, even though he started in 2013. And with this set, you get a chance to find that out. These packs definitely tend to get, kind of searched through. People try to figure out if there's a autograph or a patch card in there by looking at, sometimes, you know, the pack will be translucent. You can see more in there, or, I don't know, sometimes they'll fan them all like that. I don't know all the methods, or really any of them, but I just know these packs tend to get, like, really abused, and you will see them kind of really roughed up if you go to the store and look at them. But in any event, I get this one just because it would be fun. I thought it would be fun to open, and it was, you know, only $3.50. So with that, we'll jump in and see what we've got. So this is a 79, I think, design, and the player is Joe Morgan, who's obviously written a long since retired. So they'll have, you know, Hall of Famer players in here from way a long time ago, and they'll have modern players all using designs from like the 70s and 80s and 90s. Okay, so this is Ralph Kiner. father-son